Hi, I'm Ramgopal from presentationprocess.com. In this video, you will learn how to create animated cluster diagram in PowerPoint. The beautiful animated cluster diagram you will learn to create today looks like this. You have a core object in the middle. Then we have four allied objects. And then each of those objects leads to a cluster like this. This is a cluster diagram. Now, if you want to talk about how your company grew its products or services, you can use this useful diagram. Let me show you how. You start your story by saying, we started our business with a core proposition. Over the years, we expanded to offer four allied services. As the business grew even further, each of those allied services developed their own cluster of services like this. Can you see there are multiple ways in which you can use this cluster diagram, and I'll show you how to create this beautiful diagram from scratch. Now, as you can see, everything is created using nothing but a simple oval shape. So let us go to Auto Shapes Gallery. From Basic Shapes, let us pick up this oval tool. Hold the shift button down as you draw your circle. Then let us give this a different color. Maybe I'll use one of those shape styles here under shape format, and let us give this, say, this red color, moderate effect, red accent 2. Now let us write some text in the middle. Let us say core, and let us have this text smack in the center. So let us go to home and then go to center, and then let us go to align text and say middle. And now you have it available right in the center. If you want, you can increase the font size and font type like so that you can have something really bold in the center. Next, we are going to have four allied services coming out of this core object. So let us go to Auto Shapes Gallery once again, pick up the oval tool, and let us create a circle which is smaller than the core one. So let us have this on the side like so, and then we will have another one here, another one here, another one here. If you want to give these different colors, you can do so as well. So let me select this, and then let us go to shape format, and let us give each of them a distinct color. Maybe this green, and this one is purple, and this one is maybe orange, and for this one let us give a teal color like this. Now the important thing is we need to animate these circles in such a way that they come from the center. So how do we do that? First, you select each of these circles like so, and then apply a simple appear animation. Then we need to apply motion path animation to each of them. So let me select all these four and then add animation. I'm adding the second animation to the same object. So I need to use the option called add animation and should not use any of these because this will replace the earlier animation. So let us go to add animation. And then go down and let us choose motion path animation. So that is how the motion path happens. And let us reduce the duration to 0.5 seconds. Now we need to make a few adjustments. You can see that this one is ending over here as represented by this red arrow. So you click on that arrow and then hold the shift button down as you move it to the center. Then let us do the same for this. Let us move this to the center, and then let us pick this, and then move this to the center, and then move this to the center. Now we have got all four of them going to the center, but then we want these elements coming from the center, so we need to add reverse path direction to each of these motion path animations. So let us select the first one, go to effect options and say reverse path direction. And let us do the same thing for the second one as well, and reverse path direction. Now, this is a very important thing because since I've already added appear, these elements appear in the center and then come out, and that is where you get the effect that I had shown you earlier. And let us do the one last thing here. Go to effect options and say reverse path direction. Now you can see that these are the animation events, and the one change we need to make is this one doesn't come on click. We need to say with previous. So these four elements appear and immediately come out of the center. Let us go to slideshow mode and see how that works. We have the core shown here. On a click, four of them appear and come out. So we have got our first layer animated. Now, the second layer follows exactly the same logic. Let us create another set of circles. Let us go to Home, go to Auto Shapes Gallery. From Basic Shapes, let us pick up this Oval tool again. This time, let us have the circles slightly smaller than the second layer that we had drawn earlier. Now, let us move this over here, and all these are going to have the same green color. So let us go to Shape Fill and let us use this green color here, and let us keep the second one over here and the third one over here. Then you know the drill. All we need to do is to first select these three elements. We need to go to Animations and say Appear first, and then we need to add Motion Path Animation. So let us go to Add Animation, then say Motion Path Lines, and then we need to move the endpoints. So the first one we pick up and then say it ends at the center, and the second circle and move this over here to the center, and take the third circle and move it to the center. Now we go here and say this happens with previous, and then we need to reverse the direction of each of them and reduce the duration. So let us select all of these and say all of them happen at 0.5 seconds. And then let us go to each of these animations, go to Effect Options and say Reverse Path Direction. So we've got this coming from the center. Let us do that for this one and say Reverse Path. And let us go to this one and go to Effect Options and say Reverse Path. Now we've got all of these done. Let us bring this circle to the front and then this one to the front again. And let us go to the slideshow. You have the first layer shown and then we have the second layer shown. Now, if you follow the same logic to create the next layer for each of these circles, you will end up creating a graphic that looks like this. When I go to slideshow mode, the final result looks as beautiful as this. You just need to label it the way you want to complete the diagram. Of course, this diagram will be available to you ready-made as a template in our comprehensive all-in-one PowerPoint bundle version 2.0. Let me show you some variations of the animation that I had just taught you from our Advanced Animation Templates Bundle. This Advanced Animation Templates Bundle is available in Presentation Process website right now. I will leave a link to that product in the description box below the video. The first example from Advanced Animated Templates Bundle looks like this. We talk about one cause and ripple effects. We take the idea from pool table. So we have the first trigger and this is how things expand. Let me show you another example. Here we have one cause and ripple effects. A hand comes and clicks on the center and that causes the next level and the next level. Can you see all of these are based on the same idea? Once you have the base idea in place, you can go on to create some very interesting options, like one big idea leading to many small ideas. On a click, we show the big idea like this, and you can write your text about the big idea. And then we talk about multiple small ideas that emanate out of the big idea. Then another example is one cause, seven effects. We have one trigger, which leads to seven effects like this. If you want to keep things even simpler, you can use something like this, where we talk about five connected points, and each of the points has associated icon like this. Finally, if you want to get access to exclusive mini training courses that I share only with my newsletter subscribers, you can click on the link here, join the newsletter, and go through these useful mini training courses. Thanks a lot for watching this video. I'll see you in the next one.